y'all, welcome back, Mania with My Hectic Life Pets, where we talk about all things pet and pet related. And today we really need to talk about cycling your tank with fish in it. Now, quick disclaimer, I in no way, shape or form am suggesting that anybody run out and buy a bunch of fish and throw them in a brand new fish tank. Definitely, please, please, please do not do that. This video is more towards the people that have already bought fish and thrown them in a brand new tank and don't know what to do now because their fish are getting sick. Now, I must also apologize for if I do sound a little nasally in this video. I am suffering from a cold, so this video is brought to you by Robitussin and Echinacea tea. Doesn't taste very good, but it helps. It helps a lot. So I did already do a video that was relatively in-depth about the nitrogen cycle and how to cycle your aquarium before adding fish, which I do have a link in the description below for and should probably be popping up either here or here. I don't know what side I'm on, but I will briefly touch back over it. So basically the process is your fish poops or you throw fish food in there or there's a dying plant in there. And this creates ammonia in the tank. Ammonia is extremely toxic to fish. It is a fish killer, so you don't want any ammonia in the tank. This is where wave one of our hungry bacteria come in. This first wave of bacteria comes in and eats the ammonia and turns it into nitrites. Now, nitrites is still relatively toxic to fish, but it's not quite as toxic as ammonia. But it can still be a fish killer, so don't be fooled. This is where wave two of our bacteria come in. So we have a second wave of hungry bacteria that come in and they eat those nitrites and turn them into nitrates. Now, nitrates is gonna be the safest thing that is in the aquarium as far as these three go. And this is where our water change comes in. When we are doing our water changes, it is to remove the nitrates from the fish tank. Keeping our nitrate levels low in our tanks is extremely important, just like we want zero ammonia and zero nitrites in our fish tanks at all time. Because even the slightest amount of ammonia or nitrites in your fish tank could be detrimental to your fish's health. So moving on, you already have your fish, they're already in a tank, and your tank is not cycled yet. Do yourself a favor and go out there and get a master testing kit. These tests are so much more accurate than the test strips, and if you do take your water in to have it tested for free at pet stores, most of the time, unfortunately, they are using the testing strips and they aren't going to be able to give you as in-depth of an analysis on your water. And for all this to work, you really, really need to know exactly where all your levels are, and you need to check it pretty much on a daily basis because we have fish's lives at stake. So when we are cycling a fish tank with fish in it, a couple of recommendations that I do have: look for a higher quality water conditioner because most of them are just dechlorinators. They're just gonna remove the chlorine and chloramines from your water. And in this case, we need more than that. We need something that will also help to neutralize the toxicity of the ammonia and nitrites in the water. So I really, really love the Secom Prime, but there are other different options out there available if that is not one that is in your area or if it's a little too pricey for your budget. The other thing that you are gonna really, really need is going to be a good bacteria supplement. Secom does have Stability. There are a ton of bacteria supplements out there, but please, please get a bacteria supplement. You need to add beneficial bacteria to your aquarium because it is not established yet. These are going to be your two biggest allies in this entire process. On a bit of a side note, you might have issues with your pH that you might not realize, and if you have a fish that requires a high pH or a low pH, you need to know. You need to know what pH is required for your fish because the name of the game is getting our water quality where it needs to be. So you do want to go and do your research and find out the exact parameters for the fish that you are trying to keep. There are a ton of products out there that can help you with your pH. There's of course pH up, pH down, pH neutralizer that'll get you to that 7.0. And there are other more natural ways of things that you can add to your aquarium that will help to increase or decrease the pH. There's also a bunch of different products that can help you if you need harder water or softer water. There's all kinds of things that you can add to your filter media and that you can use even as decoration in your tanks that can help you with bringing your pH up or pH down and increasing or decreasing the hardness of your water. But for this, you need to know what parameters your fish actually requires, because if they are not kept in the correct parameters, they are gonna get sick. So now that we know what water parameters our fish actually needs to be kept in, now we can try to set ourselves up for as much success as possible. We've got our master testing kit, we've got our chemicals, so now it's time to put in the real work. Here's where things get fun. So if you are cycling a tank with fish in it, it is going to be a lot more work and you're going to have to test it far more frequently and probably do a lot more water changes than you would normally do if you are doing a fishless cycle. This is because, once again, we need to keep our water as safe as possible while the tank is cycling and getting established for our fish so that our fish don't get sick or worse, pass away. Over the past few days, I have been flooded with so many people's comments telling me that they bought a fish, they put it in the tank, they didn't cycle the tank first, and they are losing their fish, or their fish are very, very ill. Once again, this is because ammonia and nitrites are extremely, extremely toxic, even in the smallest dose. So we want to start everything off with testing the water and finding out exactly where our water parameters are. And then we can go from there. Depending on where your parameters are and how bad your water is, you may or may not have to do a very large water change. We almost need to get this water back to ground one, depending on where your levels are at. Now, if you are noticing that when you test your water, your nitrates are extremely high, you have very low nitrites, and you have zero ammonia, that means your tank is in the process of cycling. Your tank is almost there. Your tank is almost there. So you're not gonna want to do too much that might cause the tank to start over again. We don't wanna lose any of our beneficial bacteria. But if you are in the process where you are finding out that you have a ton of ammonia in the tank, we know ammonia is extremely toxic. We need to get that out of our tank. We probably need to do a pretty hefty water change. This is where having a good water conditioner that does detoxify ammonia and nitrites really, really can help you out, because there are even a lot of water supplies where the water straight out of the tap already has ammonia in it. And because of this, we really, really, really need to use that detoxifying part of the water conditioner. It will still show up on your testing that you have ammonia in the tank. It did not get rid of the ammonia. It did not send the ammonia into oblivion. I wish there was a product like that, because that would save so many fish's lives. So now that we've added our quality water conditioner, we need to add in our bacteria supplement. When you are adding bacteria in the tank, you need to shake that bottle up. A lot of the times the bacteria can settle at the bottom of the bottle and you'll think you're pouring bacteria for days, when really you're not getting any bacteria in that tank. So once we have done a good water change and we know whether or not we need to make any changes or tweaks or additions or subtractions of things in our aquarium, now we have to test our water frequently. And when I say frequently, I mean it's better to overtest than undertest, because all you're doing is finding out where your water levels are at. And ammonia can rise in your tank so fast it can make your head spin. Now, in the case of some fish, you might have the wrong tank size, which could be a huge downfall. With fish, we also want to make sure that our fish is being housed in the appropriate tank size, because if it's not in an appropriate tank size, the bio load that the fish is going to create is going to be way too much for the tank to handle and for the filter to handle. Now, I do want you to know that just because you made a mistake and you didn't cycle your tank and you made an impulse buy on fish does not make you a terrible person. Almost everyone that I know that is in this hobby, when they first started, killed at least one fish. and probably did not properly cycle their tank before adding their fish in. Just try to do better for the next time and try to take responsibility and turn things around for your fish right now. So like I said, this is gonna be a lot more work because you will have to do a lot more frequent water tests. You will probably have to do a lot more frequent water changes than you would in a cycled established tank. There are other things that you can do that can speed up the process. If you have a friend with a trusted established tank that can provide you with some of their already cycled filter media or some of their gravel, something to really help add bacteria to the tank, then this is something that could be extremely beneficial for you. But like I said, you want to make sure that it's somebody that you trust that definitely has nothing but healthy fish, because you don't want to accidentally cross-contaminate and end up with some sort of fish disease floating around in your tank. Please don't ever ask a fish store for any water or any of their gravel or filter media, because more than likely they do have fish that are carrying diseases in their tanks, and you don't want that to get into your tank, into your system, because then you're gonna have a totally different problem. So guys, if you have any more questions, go ahead and post them in the comments below. You will not get any judgment from me. And also, most of my subscribers are also really, really helpful, really kind people that love to try to help people out. I don't want anybody getting discouraged from the hobby. Just because we make a mistake doesn't mean that we're the worst people alive and should never, ever, ever be allowed to have a fish again. Back when I first started fish keeping, the only way that we could get any kind of knowledge was from the library and from buying books from an actual bookstore. There was no internet to be able to do any research. There was no YouTube. There was no nothing. We had no internet. Try not to get discouraged. Just take this and learn from your mistakes, and that's how we do better. That's how we learn to do better and be better. So anyway, guys, that's all I really have for y'all today. As always, thank you so much for watching. I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!